is an MLF subgroup company and is based in Italy, in Turin. The group deal with application, is dealing with application lifecycle management, testing, DevOps, IoT, SUA, and other units inside. Profeta and MLSoft offer to their client a proven solution and are able to manage from requirement to the deploy in production, to deploy in production. To guarantee this kind of feature, we use any kind of application. So here we use Polarion for application of cycle management, WC2 for the SOA, Jenkins, and so other many kind of application. We can start with the use case. The use case that we would like to present this day is a real use case that we have implemented to our customer. And it is an interactive incremental use case. So we start from a very small use case and then we try to improve during the project. The main problem that we have to the customer is when we install, when we do it to runtime to the SOA application, we have this kind of error. The error is something is not working, but what is not working? Where we have a problem? Normally, the services give us errors like error during authentication or ID not found or some other general functional or technical error. And it's quite difficult to understand where is an error. The other problem that we have to the customer it is that when we have an error to any kind of position of the SOA architecture, we have a lot of calling. The other colleague call us and tell us the application is not working. So we think about a solution. We think about our solution idea is to have an application that was able to help the customer to understand where the error is it, which is the services that has the error, and try to understand exactly where is the correct application that is not working, the correct services that is not working this moment. So we think about a dashboard where we can retrieve all the services that is working. We think about a light traffic where we can see the services that work or is not working with a simple red or green light. And an alarm when advice are that there is something is not working via email, for example. And a simple button where we can stop and start services. A very, very, very simple user experience where the customer can understand, can see all the services. I can understand where the services work working or not. This is the solution architect that we have, what we propose to our customer, and what we install. We think about a mobile application for the user experience. So a customer have a mobile application where we can see a list of services, and for each services can understand if the services is working or not. Not only the services that is installed inside the SOA platform, but also the endpoint services, so the backend services. We have a dashboard, so we have a web application where it is possible to see the same thing that we can say inside the mobile application. The analytics server, was the main base of this approach, that was able to retrieve data, analyze data, and pass the data inside a data repository. And then we have an application agent, with application agent is put into our application server and was able to communicate directly with application agent. And then we have an application server that was able to reproduce the dashboard into the mobile application. Which application we use to do this kind of solution? For the dashboarding, And for the analytics server, we use the data analytics server with the WSO2 application. For the application agent, we develop in Java. So we develop an agent that was installed inside the API, inside Enterprise Service Bus, and inside our application, and was able to spoke directly with a data analytics server. Then we develop a simple J2E application inside Tomcat. And this J2E application is responsible to give data to the mobile application. The mobile application, very simple, is made in Sencha. All the data that we retrieve and what we collect is put inside the Oracle database. It's the common infrastructure that we use to our customer as it was installed and running in this moment. To do this kind of operation, we use this kind of message flow. Into this message flow, we can see how the application, and how the message go through all the application. Okay, we can start from the calling services. When a client, an application call a services, he calls the services that is deployed inside the API, the gateway API. The gateway API have a custom handler. Into the custom handler, there is a directory communication to the DSS. And using a simple Java code, it was possible to persist data inside the DSS. So the services call the handler via customizing code call the DSS. After that, it's continuing to the normal flow of the calling services. The gateway connect to the enterprise service bus. The enterprise service bus in our application is used to transform protocol, to transform data, to do some transformation of the services. Inside the enterprise service bus, there is also another handler, and this handler also communicate with us. This flow is only there to us that the API is started, and also the enterprise service bus is started. After we tell to the DSS that the services is started, we continue to try enterprise service bus elaboration, and into the enterprise service bus elaboration, when we have an error, we use the BMM mediator, and with the BMM mediator, we are able to persist inside the DSS that we have this error for the specific enterprise service bus services and also for the API. We come back to enterprise service bus, we go back into the handler again. The handler tell to the DSS that all is done. We come back to the gateway, and also inside the gateway, we are able to put inside the DSS if we have an error. And also when we come back to the handler, we persist the end of API calling. So with this message flow, we are able to persist inside the database the beginning of the services, the end of the services, the beginning of API, the ending of API, if there is an error, and so the relationship to all the services that is involved for this kind of API. And then with a data analytics server, we are able to do a simple query, and we are able to understand how many time we take for each calling, and if there is an error in a specific calling. This is the API flow that we are implementing inside DSS. So we implement an event receiver, some event stream, an execution plan, and an event publisher. We simplify this one, but we have three point input point that is the event receiver. So we have an input point for API start, API stop. This one is going to sign event stream that is API service status. But the API service status is elaborated via an execution plan. A business execution plan persists inside our Oracle instances, but the service is started and stopped. And also we have an event receiver, API state error. The API state error receiver have a specific string with a specific execution plan. The execution plan of the error persists inside the DSS, the error that the error is done, and also relate do a relationship between the API that is inserted and the error. And we are able to send an email to a management of the SOA platform that there is an error in this moment. The same infrastructure. Oh, we have also an event stream where we are able to count the number of error, and we have an execution plan for and analyze the error, because we are able to understand how many error there is in a particular interval of time. If there is so much error in the same interval of time, in the interval of time, we are able to send the email to put read a particular traffic lighter. So this kind of execution plan is only to customize better the user experience of the customer. And we have the same event receiver for the enterprise service bus. So we use the DSS, also the enterprise service bus, to persist the start and the stop, and also for persist the error and to manage the error too. What's happening to the Java implementation where we have done? In the Java implementation of our little application, we use an HTTP connection to understand if the endpoint is working. Only we want to understand if the services is working or not. We don't understand if there is some functional error. Only if the service is respond, only if we don't have any kind of response. So we do an HTTP response, and this HTTP request, we analyze the response code. If we have an response post between 200 and 300, for us is okay. So the service is done. We don't want to analyze the response. Also because the backend services, in some time, we don't understand exactly what is it, because it's not our services, but it's a services for our application, so we are not able to understand exactly the message, and we are not able to have the data to put into the services to retrieve information. So we do this kind of monitoring, and we persist inside the database if we have an error or not. Why we use these kinds of solution? Because in our opinion, it's easy to implement, because the DAS is working, and it's easy to insert inside Enterprise Service Bus, inside API management, and it's easy also to implement the Java part, because the Java code that we write and we see here is a simple HTTP connection. So we have two kinds of HTTP, one HTTP, one HTTPS. The only thing that we do is analyze the response code. And the other thing is it was very, very easy to deploy. It's easy to deploy because after we deploy the DSS in cluster, the other part of this application, the Tomcat one, is a simple installation of Tomcat. And the application is a standalone application. So it's very, very easy to deploy it. And it's easy to reproduce, because we can copy-paste the DSS configuration, we copy-paste the Tomcat installation, and we can reproduce in everywhere, in every our customer. And we have, as a return, a concrete value. When which solution tell us that the services is not running. The service is not running because we don't have a 200 response. When we have too many calling in the interval of time, we have too many calling. So we have the real value of the services. And then it is possible to implement this kind of solution in interactive and incremental mode. So we can go to the customer, and it's what we have to do with our customer. And first of all, we install the simple Apache application. And then we can say which of the services are running or not. And then we introduce the DSS. And so we can retrieve some information. And when we customize the DAS, and we refine the user interface. So is it possible to install this kind of solution in interactive and incremental mode? The performance of this solution is guaranteed by the clustering. The database clustering, we use the customer Oracle clustering, the DSS clustering, and then the application server Tomcat can be installed in redundant mode. It's not necessary to install Tomcat in cluster because the simple application that installing inside Tomcat is like a standalone application. So I can install this application in any server, and I can use any instance of this application to retrieve information that we need. The management of this solution is very easy and not complex because we use the DAS user interface. So into the DAS user interface, we have all the information when we need. We can write down the code for manage the data, and the Apache application have in this moment only one configuration file. And this configuration file is a Java property file, so very, very, very easy. And also, not technical people can compone this this file with a specific endpoint of the services that we would like to analyze. What we have to do? We create an application that was able to retrieve the problem. Like the dog, but we help human to retrieve the transfer. So in our opinion, the error inside so sometimes is so difficult to retrieve because you don't understand exactly where is it. So like a tartar, you have a green place, but you don't know where is it. If you have something like a dog, but he was able to retrieve exactly where is it, you can find a lot of it. And so we create something that was able to retrieve a problem, tell exactly in my infrastructure where is the error, and then was able to visualize the error. I have a simple list where I have the application name and a simple button with red or green color. And then I can visualize in any kind of way, inside mobile application, inside web application, is a simple way to help customer to understand if this application is working, if the SOA is working or not. Okay, thank you.